Hi, Delby, and thank you for joining the Positive Image Movement with me. We would like to start by you introducing yourself.
Sure. Hello, everybody. My name is Delby Bragais. I'm an internationally certified image consultant and a fashion designer. I have been helping a lot of women of all nationalities, races, colors, body types, etc., celebrate their individuality. And it's my pleasure to be here with you today.
Oh, wow. I'm sure we'll have a lovely session with you.
Fabulous.
So let's start by you telling us what are the major issues women face related to their image and they don't accept it.
Okay, so let me just share with you the result of a lot of interactions. I'm talking about thousands of interactions with different women from different parts of the world. I've had the opportunity to customize and design fashion for different types of women. So broken down generally, number one, it's something is not right with my body or my body type. So we're talking about not accepting their huggable or round body type, or perhaps wanting more proportion and balance for their triangle body type, wherein you have full hips and narrow shoulders, smaller breasts, and a little bit of shorter legs sometimes. So, or also wanting balance with the direct opposite of that. Or we're talking about like a swimmer's body or the inverted triangle, where you have broad shoulders, but you have slim hips and long legs usually. So, and then you have the up and down type of body, or sometimes called the rectangle. So there are certain women who are not given curves, so they usually have what we call up and down type of body. The waist to hip ratio is really not so much, so you don't see a lot of curves. And there's a saying, you always want what is on the other side of the mountain. So people who are very curvaceous want, sometimes they want a little bit of less of it, and the ones who want more curves, you know, feel that they are despondent because they don't have what they want. So those are different types of bodies that we see prevalently. And of course, there's the petite person who always wanted to look taller, and the big girl type. These are women who are usually gifted with bigger bones. They're usually taller, and they want to look a little bit more frail or dainty or smaller bone. So like I said, these are what I observe that some women want in terms of body type. Well, the second one, which is also very prevalent in Asia, is skin tone, skin color. And it could be, of course, related to race, meaning to say a lot of Asians might want to be more fair. I want a lighter skin color compared to perhaps others. While other women who are really, really fair feel that I am too pale, I lack color, so I want to be more tanned or a little bit darker skin. So you see, it's color also and skin, and it's race related, genetically given. And then there is also certain features of women that again are cultural or race related. Like women sometimes, this is not body, but I'm talking about certain types of features. Like some women with chinky eyes like to have those big doe eyes, and you know what I'm saying, deep set, but you don't have that. So that's not exactly body type per se, but those are certain desires of some women who want what they don't have. So I think we as image consultants can help them in terms of actually espousing celebrating yourself, celebrating your individuality, which happens to be my style motto and my personal branding motto also. Because as I shared with you earlier, I'm doing a lot of personal branding coaching. So celebrate your individuality is actually very meaningful and powerful for women. However, you cannot just take them on a journey because like I said, it's a journey. So sometimes it takes time. There's ups and downs. So we as image consultants can help them during this journey by perhaps doing some consulting and recommendations to help them with come up with solutions for whatever it is that is troubling them when it comes to their body type.
Right, very rightly said. So let's talk about how we can help them do the illusion dressing as you were saying in the earlier conversation.
Okay, so major body types, of course there are different types, but we can break it down into simply the major ones. First, we have people who are, let's start with the triangle. So for those body types which have smaller or narrow shoulders and ample full hips, and they usually have a behind that's ample also, usually these women are not big breasted, and for this the objective is really to balance the top and the bottom half of the body. So in terms of fabrication, there are more angular bodies that are like this, or there are also more curved bodies that are like this. However, I would say that in terms of fabrics, they can wear fabrics that are drapeable, drapey, and that have a little bit of give to it, or a little bit of elasticity. And we can be putting shoulder pads or a little bit of help on the shoulder area to balance. All design details, we're talking about beadwork, if we're talking about career dressing, we're talking about suits, we're talking about executive wear, all colors and design details can be on the upper part of the body. And if it is for special occasion dressing, you know, all like if you're putting feathers, if you're putting Swarovski crystals and all of those other details that call attention, you can put them all on the upper part of the body while keeping the lower part more simple. And in terms of coloring of clothing, usually it's a good rule that the upper part is more light in terms of color, it throws off color, and the lower part is darker. So of course it's very important if we're talking about proportion, it's important that this person is either you understand whether the person is like elongated, because you can be tall but still triangular, and you can be super petite and short and still triangular. So those come into play, but the bottom line is balance and design details all on top, colors light on top, darker at the bottom, and also decorations, etc., lapels and collars, good for this type of body. They're going to be on the upper part, of course. And of course, when you look at the lines, directions, very important, internal lines and external lines. When we're talking about the internal lines of a garment, you will see that this type of body will look better when, let's say, the lapels are pointing outward. So it elongates and it makes the top part more broad in terms of the direction the eye follows. So the lines of the garments are very important. Also, if you're going to be looking at the lower part, women with this kind of body would benefit from really simple silhouettes for the lower part. No layering, like as in sometimes we have skirts that are layered, etc. No ruffles, no pockets. Like if you start putting pockets, you're adding more fabric to the lower part of the body. So it actually bulks up the part that you want to subdue. You want to come up with a good balance of top and bottom. So those are small details that you might want to consider if you have a triangular body type.
Okay. Also, tell us, if a person has to attend an interview, what is the best way he can or she can present herself for the interview to look the best and be very confident?
Okay, I have a question for you. Are we talking about a person in general to attend an interview, or are we talking about a person with a triangular type of body?
Let's talk about the triangle one.
Okay, I agree with you. You know why? Because 80% of the world's population of women are triangles. Yes. So if you belong to that, do not feel bad, because that is a normal woman's body. So, okay, agreed. Let's talk about that. If you're going to go for an interview, you're applying for a job, then first of all, ask yourself, what industry am I applying for? Because as against a standard recommendation, I would rather you ask yourself certain questions, and based on the answer, you determine which path you're going to take and which types of clothing will be best for you. If you are applying for a position in a finance company or in a company like law, you're applying for a law office, finance office, an accounting firm, anything that has to do with money, etc., then know that that kind of industry leans towards more formal types of dressing. Anything related to money, you have to be careful when it comes to that. So I would recommend something that is more of a basic suit. A basic suit which is a little bit perhaps on the neutral side. So these are colors like navy or khakis, mochas, or you know, colors that are not like very, very out there, like orange, etc. So we're not talking about that. We're talking about neutral colors, corporate or professional colors, and a basic suit, either with pants or a skirt, jacket with pants or skirt, three-piecer would work, or a two-piecer would also work. Also, it depends on the position. Number one is the industry. Number two, the position. Of course, if you are applying for a position that is an intern, let's say you're interning, etc., nobody's expecting you to go there dressed to the nines in a killer's power suit. However, if you are applying for an executive position, then perhaps coming across as more powerful, more confident, and having that third piece like a jacket would really be helpful for you. Very well made, very well tailored and flattering for your body. Like I said, depending on the position, nobody is going to expect somebody who just graduated from college to come in with a killer power outfit. But if you are going to be interviewed, I mean, let's be honest, for a pretty high up position, then it pays to arrive perhaps in power dressing, very well chosen, great fabrication, crease resistant, darker colors, and of course, accompanied by loads of self-confidence. So one, industry. 2, talking about the position. 3, of course, we're talking about the specific body type. I already shared with you tips on how to complement and balance that kind of body type. So, of course, the more visually appealing and impactful you are, sends a message. And the message is that you took the time to present yourself in a professional way that is flattering for you, your specific body type. So that says something about you and most probably the work that you're going to be doing for this company. And lastly, of course, you also have to check the environment. When I say environment, I'm talking about the time of year. Of course, if you're being, I don't know, do you have winter in India?
Yes.
But
yes,
if
yes.
You know, because this is a global audience, so anywhere you are, of course, if it's summer, chances are you're going to be wearing summer colors or summer suits, you know, lighter shades vis-a-vis like fall and winter, where, you know, you have changes in color and fabric and texture. So aside from, of course, the environment, I'm not only talking about the season, I'm talking about the specific part of the world that you are going to, because there are certain types of the parts of the world that they really dress up, or they're more conservative. And there are parts of the world that are a little bit more laid back. So based on those 4 criteria, the industry, the position, of course, your body type, and the environment you're in, then those all can help you determine the best way to present yourself and the best outfit.
Oh, wow. I think we had an amazing session and a very informative one. Thank you for joining and being a part of Positive Image Movement. What an amazing session from your side, Delby. How was your experience and what do you feel about the Positive Image Movement?
I feel fabulous about the Positive Image Movement, and I think that it is a great movement addressing women's challenges in today's world. And I think it is a great initiative. I congratulate you and all of the other women who are going to be supporting you from here on. And also, it is part of a great change that I am seeing, that I'm feeling right now globally, where women are helping women, as we talked about earlier, and all of us have our own specific gifts, and we're sharing our gift. You're sharing your gift to other women. So it is my hope that a lot of women get benefit from these interviews that you have been painstakingly, you know, undertaken with different speakers from different parts of the world. And I do hope it benefits them. Let's all celebrate our individuality.
Thank you so much for being a part of it. I'm so lucky that you are one of the speakers.
My pleasure.
Thank you.